preventing climate change is crucial for stability and growth in emerging markets because these areas will be among the first to feel the impact. That's what the CEO of Unilever told CNN at the COP21 Climate Conference in Paris. Paul Polman told John Sutter that businesses have to step up and do their part.
Business has an enormous role to play. You just take, for example, the emerging markets where we will see most of the issues of climate change show up before anywhere else. There's less resilience and population growth, urbanization in the wrong spots. And business in that part of the world is about 60% of the GDP, 80% of the financing flow, and 90% of the job creation. Business itself is an enormous carbon emitter through its value chain, and also is, in fact, the receiver of all the negatives if we don't take the mitigation. The volatility in prices of, let's say, raw materials, agriculturally based raw materials, the economies themselves that don't function, and the stress that that brings with it. So it's not surprising that you see businesses rapidly getting involved in all parts of the world, not only from a mitigation or a risk management point of view, but also the enormous opportunities that that new economy is increasingly offering all of us.
We hear a lot of talk about how expensive it might be to fight climate change. I'm wondering if you think there's a business case for cutting emissions.
Well, there are costs that need to be borne. For example, the mitigation things, that the resilience that need to be built, because some of the effects are already here. You see it today again in the papers. We go from India to parts of the US to other parts of the world. It's now a daily occurrence. So there are costs that we are all incurring, but increasingly it's also clear that there are enormous benefits if we can unlock that new greener economy. The 100 billion now looks like everybody is in agreement as of 2020 that we have that, but the 100 billion itself would not be enough to deal with all these issues to transform the economy. But what it does is, if the governments come out here with a clear and ambitious agreement, if they come with a net zero target or a carbon neutrality target, then business will get a clear signal, and these 100 billion of funds will unleash the trillions that are needed to transform these economies. I'll give you a very quick, very simple example. Urbanization, 50% of the world population now living in cities. That's 3.5 billion people out of the 7 billion people. Urbanization will move to about 10 billion people, 70% living in cities. That's another 3.5 billion people. So in the next 30, 40 years, we need to build as many new cities in this world as we currently have. That means in New York every 2.5 months. It means a total investment of $90 trillion. How we are going to make these investments over the next 15 years will decide how we're going to live for a longer time. Cities like London still have the road systems from the Roman times. So it's not that we need significantly more money, I don't believe that. It's just that we need to spend the money smartly to not lock ourselves in a high carbon growth model, which will be unsustainable.
How do you convince your shareholders that this is the right thing to do?
Well, the job is done, it's easier by the day, because the effects of climate change are increasingly there and it's internalized in companies. When you have a drought in Brazil or a drought in California, when you don't have access to water that you need to run your factories, you have to move your factories with the cost. Consumers will take less showers or wash their hair less, and you see it reflected in the markets that are going down. Every day now you'll see the cost of climate change actually coming in, and interestingly, businesses see it well before governments do, because it hits the P&L first.